I have fed more drug fiends than the top three pharmaceutical companies combined. I have stolen children from parents, wives from husbands, wiped out entire generations. But lying, that I have never done. The rest are offenses against humanity. Lying is an offense against yourself. I am the head of the Santa Blanca organization, which you call a cartel. I had a dream. I dreamed of a land where we could grow our own coca, produce our own cocaine, where we could run our business free from interference from the police, the government, the army, the Yankees. In my dream, a woman's voice asked me,
"Sueño, mijo, what if you had your own country?"
Like Moses, I led my people to the promised land, Bolivia. We came here. We bought the coca fields. What we couldn't buy, we took. We bought the police, the military, the judges, the politicians. We were on the verge of becoming the government itself, on the razor's edge from fulfilling my dream. Of creating a narco-state. The nation of Santa Blanca.
Last week, a crude explosive detonated outside the U.S. Embassy in La Paz, Bolivia. Two Marine Embassy guards were injured in the blast. 2 days later, a CIA asset in central Bolivia provided us with these images. Our analysts have identified the individual in the photo as DEA Special Agent Ricardo Ricky Sandoval, my friend. Sandoval had spent the last 6 years investigating the local cocaine industry. Our understanding is that Sandoval was the intended target of the bombing. What the embassy bomb did not accomplish was completed up close and personal. Sandoval was captured, tortured, and killed. Then his body was dumped. We have yet to recover it. Our target, the group responsible for the embassy bombing and the death of Special Agent Sandoval, is the drug trafficking organization commonly known as the Santa Blanca Cartel. Yesterday, they were just narcos. Today, they're narco-terrorists. Initially, the Bolivian government resisted the Mexican cartel. They formed UNIDAD, a Bolivian Special Forces unit. It didn't go as planned. Thousands of bodies later, politicians, police officers, and journalists have become an endangered species. The Bolivian government has imploded on itself. With no other options, the new president made a deal with Santa Blanca. You stop killing our people, we'll look the other way. Since then, Santa Blanca has turned Bolivia into the nexus of the South American drug trade. With their friends in Mexico, they also have a clear pipeline to the US and Canada. The only way to stop Santa Blanca for good is to completely dismantle them, piece by piece. The cartel is organized into four operations: production, smuggling, security, and influence. At the top of it all is El Jefe de los Jefes, boss of bosses, El Sueño.
Look, I'm your resident spook for this ride. Welcome to Operation Kingslayer.
Our briefing said there'd be a contingent of locals.
The Qatar is 26. They're a group of rebels who've been giving UNIDAD and Santa Blanca some resistance. We'll meet their leader, Pacatari, as soon as we touch down. Bolivians have a long history of hating us Yankees, but this time, let's hope the enemy of my enemy will be my friend. But don't turn your back on him. I'm not going to.
soldiers. This is the help you promised? That Sandoval promised? A single Yankee died, so you send a handful of soldiers. Hundreds of Bolivians have died from Santa Blanca's bullets. Where will my hundreds of soldiers come from?
As Americans, we aren't here, remember? These soldiers are the best covert ops team our country has to offer. With their help, you won't need hundreds of soldiers.
Are you familiar with the word Huber, Senora Bowman?
Meet Pak Atari, leader of the resistance group Qataris 26. We will be working with the rebels to destabilize Santa Blanca's organization. They've been fighting Santa Blanca and corrupt Bolivian officials for nearly 6 years now. We'll need to coordinate targets.
There's no time for this. We have information on Amaru's whereabouts.
Amaru? You found him? Amaru is one of the founders of the Qataris 26.
More than that, her group is founded on his ideas. Without his theories of an agrarian proletariat, there would be no organized resistance against Santa Blanca and the corruption in our government. Amaru must be saved. If you were to assist my people, it would do much to earn my confidence.
Where is he?
We do not know exactly. We know he is in this province and that there is a Santa Blanca lieutenant who knows where he is.
I'll put a call into the activity, see if they can dig more intel out of the airwaves. Start looking for that lieutenant and keep me informed of everything via sat phone. Good hunting.
Saving Amaru is important to our cause, Yankee. Make sure you don't kill the Santa Blanca lieutenant before you get the chance to ask him questions.
So welcome guys, today, as you can see right there, we're going to be playing Ghost Recon Wildlands. Love this game, love the look of it, like, I've always loved Ubisoft games, and this one just honestly reminds me of Far Cry.
I tell you, I'm not too comfortable working with Pak Atari and these rebels, their kind of ideology always ends up...
I didn't want to start my commentary until now, because...
End of the day, this is a revenge mission.
But I didn't want to start talking, because obviously, most people get annoyed with people talking over the cutscenes, obviously, I wanted you guys to understand what was going on. So yeah. I honestly love the graphics in this game, they're like, they are amazing. But yeah, if you guys do enjoy this video, please like and subscribe for more regular content on this channel. Let's see if we can hit 10 likes for this vid. That's my like goal for today. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoy. Never ever done any gameplay walkthroughs on my channel until now. This will be my first one that goes on the channel, so it's gonna be good. What I'm gonna do with this game is, because it's an open world game like Far Cry was, where you have to sort of roam around the map, there's a bunch of side missions, stuff like that, I'm only gonna show you the story and I'll like sort of tell you like as every gameplay video comes out about like what I've been like earning and everything, like so upgrade my guy off camera, get him some new gear and stuff like that, new skills, and then on camera I'll do more of the story, because otherwise it just gets too boring. I'm just gonna be doing the same thing over and over again, which is basically just gonna be taking over bases. But yeah, I'm looking forward to this, man. It's gonna be good. It's gonna be fun. I like how, unlike Far Cry though, the driving isn't so complex on this game. It's another thing I do like. I am also, you guys will notice that in games like this, I like to go for the stealth option. I'm not one of those run and gun people. I just find it more fun to do the stealth. And also, it just makes things less hectic, more organized sort of thing. Okay. So I've just got the same gun then. Oh no, this is the MP5. Nice, I'm glad they've added in the MP5 in this game. I love that gun. Modern Warfare flashbacks, as you guys know. So yeah.
Bad guys in the area.
Okay. There he is, I see him up there. How do you use the drone? Because I've heard there's a drone in this game. I want to know how to use it. Alright, yeah, I see now.
Drone is airborne.
So. Alright then.
I'm getting a position.
How does this work then?
Ready to fire.
I don't understand that. Can I sync someone else? Oh, my drone is going out of range. I'm going to have to upgrade the range and the battery at some point. So I can use that drone for longer. Down there, I really need a sniper for this type of thing. Off camera, I'm gonna grind up, try to get a sniper with a suppressor on it. So, and like also a sight for this gun. So then,
don't want to switch the target. Switch to suppressors.
Do myself much easier. I'm loving the look of this game though. Graphics are amazing. Like, it's just unreal how far graphics have gone. How far gaming has gone. Can I get this guy? Yeah. Nice. Didn't
hear that. Eyes on the target. Let's move.
No. Cool. Alright. Now I'm closer, I might be out. Alright, so. But yeah. If you guys want to... Just in case you guys don't know, I am playing on Advanced Difficulty, which is the second from Hardest. I believe it's Advanced. I can't remember what it's called now, but I'm playing on the second Hardest Difficulty in the game because I just wanted to challenge myself a bit more. You guys know how I like it. I love the challenge. Just like most gamers, really. Most gamers love a challenge because it's just what makes the game more fun. I mean, if you're playing on easy mode, then it's just stupid because the enemies are just weird. Like,
tango number three.
Why would you even want to? Alright. Thing is if I shoot this guy. Oh no, oh no, oh no, oh dear. Oh dear. Pop up, pop your head up. Oh no. Oh dear. Alright, cool, I got him. But now they're gonna know. Now they're gonna know.
Enemy reinforcements incoming.
Gonna break.
Those assholes are going the wrong way.
Alright. This is so hard to use without a sight or a sniper.
What the hornet's nest?
Some guns don't have the greatest of eyesight. Everybody do the flop. anyone who's watched that channel on YouTube, we know what I'm talking about. Those videos, I can't remember what they're called now. But everybody do the flop was something I used to find really funny back in the day. Most of you guys probably don't know what I'm on about. Alright. Nice. Using a ghillie suit and an MP5, that really does remind me of Modern Warfare. I cannot lie. And then Call of Duty strayed away from ghillie suits and turned into all colourful outfits and taunts. And what is this? Food passes. Okay. I'll rate it. Something for... I don't know who that goes to. I think it goes to the Rebels. What do I do in this situation? I mean, there's like, oh man, what do I do? Sorry guys if I'm playing slow right now, but I'm just trying to get used to stealth again, because I haven't been stealthy in a long while. Like, the last open world game I played where I had to use stealth was Far Cry 3. And I haven't played that in a while. So sorry if I'm a little bit rusty at the moment. But after a few goes I'll back to where I was. Back in Garden again. Is there someone in here? Oh, oh no, oh dear. I can be revived? That's epic. You gonna revive me? Ow.
Thanks.
You're thanking him for stabbing you. Okay. Nah, I know that as a syringe. Be stupid to not know.
Shit, they're headed this way. What should we do?
We should run! No, I'm kidding. Running would be a stupid idea. So then. I wonder how many revives I get, because surely I'm not just going to keep on going down for a revive. Ow! See what I mean by this difficulty? Now you know for sure that I am in this difficulty. In easy difficulty, the enemies are stupid, they would not spot you. But in this difficulty, they are very eagle-eyed. They know what they're doing, and they will see you. Alright. So attempt to...
Yo, we got hostiles. Hey, we got an arco with a submachine gun. Over by the sandbag emplacement.
Alright, so we found Mr. Lieutenant. Now, we just need to find out where Amaru is. First, we need to deal with this guy. Are you serious? I had the suppressor on. Oh, wow. Of course he did. Of course. He alerted him. Am I gonna... Oh, well. Got you. Oh, no. Oh, no, 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 no.
Here's the deal, asshole. You answer my questions, or I put a bullet in your gut and leave you to die in your own shit. No entiendes?
Chill the fuck up, cabrón! What do you want?
Amaru. Where can I find him?
You serious?
Come on.
That's what this is about?
Tell me.
He's at Atoya Farm.
No. Come on, tell me now, tell me now, tell me now. Shut up, shut up, shut up, shut up, shut up, shut up, shut up. Alright, let's go, let's go, let's go. I know where Amara is, I know where Amara is. Alright. Probably gonna skip out the drive and just get you there right now. Alright. Aha. Okay, so that's what synchronized shot is then. So that's the thing I did on the first mission. That's cool. That'll help me a lot. So that's the use of the... That'll be a big use of the ghosts, who are the people I'm working with. Well, that's what I'm calling them anyway, because that's what I think they're called. Okay. So yeah. Oh, Amaru. My man. My boy, my home dog. Got him. I'm coming, Amaru. I'm gonna free you from this place. And you better thank me, because most guys I free these days don't thank me, and it's not very nice, considering all I go for. Considering all I go for is to try and get to them. And then it's just like, nope, nope, you could have done it faster or something like that. Ooh, over here. But I don't want these guys to see me. This seems like the average type of place. A farm is always the type of place you'd see drugs being grown. Do they know? Are you serious? The guy was right next to them. I guess they don't care. Alright then. Well, I'll just be... Anyone here? No. Here then. Alright, he's down. Yeah, you continue rambling your crap, but I'm just gonna take you all out and grab Amaru and get out of here. I hear someone. Oh. Yeah, let's move out of the way before I'm seen.
They're gonna be on top of us in another few seconds.
Oh dear. Oh dear, I'm gonna have to go prone, aren't I? Oh, they're gonna find me, aren't they? Oh no. What do I do? Do I shoot him? Alright. Alright, he's dead. Oh. There's another one. Surely though it wouldn't be a wise decision to come round here if there's just a lump of grass just a bush just laying here, taking all your guys out. Surely it would not be a smart decision to go round to the area where the guy is shooting down everyone. Alright then. He's going that way. I guess I could just... Oh. Okay, they're both gone. Just look in the area where no one has been taken out. Yeah, why not? Okay. Oh, is that everyone?
We're clear over here.
Nice.
There's a weapons case over here.
Nice. Alright. Ooh, equipment. Just in case it's unlocked weapon upgrades. Nice. Panoramic sight. Yeah, boy. Ooh, baby. Got my first sight unlocked. And it was on camera. So you guys have seen me progress a little bit. Tag supply. More supplies for, I'm guessing, the rebels.
So the rebels can pick up the supplies.
Yeah,
later.
The rebels. Alright, I wonder how these supplies benefit you though, or if they benefit you at all. But surely they would have some sort of use other than, oh yeah, just help the rebels. Or anything else? Anything I need to know? Ah. Oh. Okay. Alright then. So that's how I put the sight on. So. My character looks dope though. Alright, so I haven't unlocked any other weapons yet. How do I put the thing on? Oh, there we go. Any good camos? Surprised these are all unlocked already. So. Ooh, that one looks sick. That reminds me of that dragon scale camo from Modern Warfare Remastered, but in green instead of red. Where is it? There it is. Actually, it doesn't look so much like dragon scale. But, whatever. Aha! There you are. Ah, it's just the iron sights. And that bad boy right there. Anything else unlocked? No? 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 No. Okay then. I probably won't swap out the suppressor though. No. Alright then. I'll keep that as is for now. Yeah. Man, I love this game. I can't wait to be to start earning more stuff for it. Because, like, that means then I'm just gonna, like, my character's gonna get better and better, making the game much easier to do. But yeah, I'm gonna definitely have to do a lot of grinding side missions and, like, off camera, because of the fact that I'm gonna need more stuff. Like, in this type of game, where it's, like, open world, you're gonna need to be prepared, especially on the difficulty I'm on. Can't just go straight into story. Hey Amaru, how you doing? You okay? Are you gonna leave the cage, or are you just...
What's left of him anyway?
There you go.
Come on, I'm getting you out of here.
I thought you were gonna be one of those people who's just like, yay, I'm free, but I'm not gonna leave. Ooh, a chopper. I'll take that.
Nice. I got escape.
Hey, come on.
Has begun.
Back to your friends.
Entonces, Pacatari has made his deal with the malditos extranjeros.
Take it up with him, senor.
Oh. Okay, then. How do you fly this thing up and over the mountain? Please don't say it's going to be like Far Cry. Oh, okay. There we go. There we go. Now we're gaining height. This is sort of like GTA flying, but sort of not at the same time. Like, it's got a bit of GTA, Far Cry, and Mafia in it. GTA because of the driving and flying mechanics, and also the shooting. Kinda. And then Far Cry just because of the feels. It's a Ubisoft game. It's gonna have those types of feels. And then Mafia because you gotta take out all the underbosses to get to the overboss. Alright, well let's drop off Amaru then. And then that will be the end of the beginning to Ghost Recon Wildlands.
This is it.
I want to try and get a proper landing though, like, I like things to be professional, like, I want it to make sense, not just land next to, oh god, land next to the building. This seems like a perfect spot. Alright then.
Hey.
Come along now, Amaru. Ooh, more equipment. Yes, please. What's this? Ooh, it's a sniper, yes! Perfect. No. Damn, man. At least I got a sniper now. So it's two things you guys have seen me get off on camera. As much as I like the camo that I've got on my assault rifle, I don't like all my weapons having the same camo. Oh, I want that. I need to earn that. I need to get that so bad. That suits a sniper. Alright. Anything else? Damn, that looks dope. Alright. Pick up ammo. And let's drop off Amaru. Right here, right now.
Are you hurt?
No, of course not. He's just painted. They just decided to practice their art on him.
These Aucas, these demons, they had questions to me.
Let us see.
Their talk of love was enough to make me vomit. But their methods were not.
Were their names Yuri and Polito?
Si, Yuri and Polito.
These are the fucks that tortured Ricky Sandoval while Sueño questioned him. I want them back.
He looks like a man.
But I haven't seen Yuri and Polito in at least 3 days, maybe four. I don't know where they are now.
We need more intel.
We'll search every village and camp until we find something.
Somebody's gotta know something. Gather documents, hack computers, interrogate hostile lieutenants, talk to civvies, whatever it takes.
We'll turn over every rock.
Alright. Well, hope you guys enjoyed the first part to this. Maybe walkthroughs, maybe become a regular thing on my channel. Definitely gonna be enjoying this game though. So yeah, hope you guys enjoyed, like and subscribe if you do, and see you next time.